before. Yes, it is Groundhog Day. And we welcome you to this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan with Hall of Famer Doris Burke and Greg Anthony, giving us the rundown from the sideline courtside, David Aldridge. And we've got a moment now to check out the Eastern Conference standings and see where everyone is sitting as things begin to settle down just a bit through the midway point of the season. You take a look at the Magic. They're down at the seventh position right now. A decent start to the season, but they're looking to make a move.
And when I look at Orlando, they're one of those teams that hasn't quite figured it out this year. A lot of talent, a lot of heart, but nothing to put them up on that next level.
You know, it's got to be frustrating for them. You can't dwell on the past. You've got to think forward, work together, and play for one another.
A look at the starting group for the Magic. Outside the wings are Suggs and Wagner. Then there's Black. Then there's Bancaro. And it's Bitadze in at the five down low. And for Minnesota, the two towering figures inside for him, Towns and Gobert. The wing set for him, Edwards and McDaniel. And it's Conley in at the point. And when you consider how athletic Doris Polk these teams are, what do you think both should be looking to do here tonight?
Well, Kevin, athleticism is best showcased in transition, so we expect the pace to be high. There is going to be pressure at the rim. The potential for the spectacular could happen on any moment.
Now here's Towns. Playing Dallas, he was nearly unstoppable. Wagner passes to Suggs. Bancaro outside. There's a good screen to the paint. There's Bitadze. It's hauled in by Edwards. And so Edwards will bring it up for the Timberwolves. Outside Conley. The Timberwolves working the ball around now. Gobert finds Edwards. Over Suggs. Edwards can't hit.
Well, that's a blown defensive coverage, but it doesn't matter. He cannot answer the bell.
Wagner passes to Black. Here's Bancaro. Pass to Wagner. Six on the shot clock. Back to Black. Gobert with the block.
One of the best to do it. Gobert adds another block to that career total. Three straight misses to begin the game. Not the start they were hoping for.
Here's Wagner. 2 points. That one goes.
And finally, somebody knocks down a shot. This has not been pretty thus far.
For Rudy Gobert, he is one of four players, Doris, to win Defensive Player of the Year 3 times.
And you think back, Kevin, he was a late first-round pick in 2013, probably has exceeded all expectations. He has obviously cemented himself as one of the all-time defenders in NBA history.
Out to the right wing. Bancaro, Rudy Gobert with the rebound.
Just one made field goal in 5 tries. Not a good start.
And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. Out to Edwards. Three-pointer. Rebound by the Magic. Their last encounter was in Orlando.
Yeah, I remember last time they met up, they just got ran out of the building. They weren't too happy with some of the calls in that game either.
Yeah, their starters got into foul trouble, and it felt as if some of the calls were ticky-tack, no doubt, but nonetheless, damage was done. Well, that's not the guy you want guarding him at the rim. Just too much of a differential in terms of size.
So the Timberwolves called their first timeout. Well, a chance to check out some stats for Carl Anthony Towns.
And his three-point shooting has gotten a lot better over his last 10 games. He looks so much more comfortable from beyond. There's no doubt he's got the green light to let it fly whenever the shot's there for him.
Timberwolves trail by four. Now here's Conley. We saw him with 10 points last game.
Well, Anthony Edwards has the kind of frame and skill set that can make him a force. But it all comes down to paying the price and putting in the work now.
It's his first trip to the line.
And that 84% free throw percentage is a testament to all the hard work he's put in on the line.
Free throw good, Edwards. And Doris, we are right in the middle of the season now, and we've seen quite a few surprises so far, don't you think?
You know, it's interesting to me, Kevin, is you never know exactly what's going to happen. Some teams outperform expectations, some obviously fall short. What's most fascinating to me are the few players who find a way to take their game to the next level. That's exciting.
And Edwards drops them both.
You want to contest this guy's shot, but you absolutely don't want to send him to the line. He will make you pay.
And Caro outside. A minute 50 left to play in the first. Down to five on the shot clock, and that one is good.
Well, efficiency is everything, right? So far in this one, this guy has been on the money.
And here's Edwards. He'll bring it up for the Minnesota Timberwolves. Takes the three. The Timberwolves again can't hit.
Right now trying to get into a rhythm, but so far this quarter, boy, he is struggling to make anything go down.
Has to be Johnson. Orlando moving the ball around. The pass to Black. Shoots the three. Gobert pulls it in. Timberwolves trail by four. Outside Conley. Here's Towns. That's tipped.
How about that denial by Paolo Banchero? Nice to see him put that frame to use.
Towns, a screen on Wagner. Tries again. A nice shot by McDaniel.
And the lack of effort to fight over the screen there makes that an easy shot.
You know, we see this all the time. You're basically, as a defender, hoping the man misses rather than putting in the work to get over screens.
And it's the Magic with the ball, following the bucket by the Timberwolves. Pass to Suggs. Here's Black, covered by Conley. There's Wagner with the three. And the three ball is good. Wagner's got 5 points so far.
What we know about Franz Wagner is this guy attempts a fair amount of threes for a reason. He's pretty effective, guys.
Edwards with it. One of the most consistent producers in the league. He's averaging around 25 and a half points a game. From deep three-point land, and the last second attempt doesn't fall. And we reach the end of the first quarter. Magic lead by five. After this break, we'll be back with the start of the second quarter on 2K Sports. And thanks again for tuning in. If you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter of action so far. And when you consider how the Magic are doing, what do you think?
You got to credit their defense, communicating, rotating, making plays on the ball.
Yeah, I think they wanted to come out of the gate strong, and they have. They've taken the early lead here.
Looking at the last game for the Minnesota Timberwolves, it was a win against Dallas. This is how the floor looks for the Magic starting the second. They've got Wagner. Cole Anthony is out there with Markelle Fultz. Then it's Wendell Carter, and it's Ben Carroll in at the three spot. Timberwolves trail by five. Well, they're still young, but the Magic, Greg, are becoming one of those league pass teams. Like people want to watch them.
Yeah, I mean, they've got some players, leaving aside any rooting interest on my part. They've got some young fellas that are definitely intriguing to watch.
Anthony with it, picked up by Edwards. Passes it to Fultz. Bancaro outside. Six to shoot. Here's Alexander Walker. He's covered by Bancaro. Edwards against Anthony. Edwards looking it over. And it's Wagner with the rebound.
Those are chances almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points, but you need just enough to keep him out of rhythm.
Well, Markelle Fultz continues to develop his floor awareness. Passes like that will create all kinds of chemistry.
Just about a minute and a half has gone by here in the second. Anthony against Edwards. Pass to Alexander Walker. Count that one. Alexander Walker's got his first basket of the night.
And that's an example of playing big, adapting to the situation.
Well, major height disadvantage. He recognizes that and still able to score it.
Stolen by Anderson. Oh, and here comes Anderson all alone.
Dunk contest. Go ahead, young sir. What a finish.
Awesome rewind courtesy of the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Here's Fultz. He has yet to score. And the pass to Wagner. He kicks it to Anthony. Carter with a screen on Edwards. Goes up the baseline, and the jumper is good. And the Magic lead by five.
This guy is so creative with such an excellent handle. Nice drive by Cole Anthony.
And the Timberwolves call time here. Doris, when you and I think about the playoffs back in the bubble, you can see how much of an impact the fans have during games.
Personally, Kevin, I hope never to see a bubble again because the energy and the atmosphere inside NBA arenas is so electric you can almost reach out and touch it. And obviously, the players love the opportunity to perform in front of their home fans.
Big group substitution now for Minnesota. Rudy Gobert is checked in for Reed. Towns comes in for Kyle Anderson. McDaniels is checked in for Alexander Walker. And it's Mike Conley in for Shake Milton. Orlando also making some changes. Goga Bitadze is checked in for Wendell Carter. Jalen Suggs comes in for Wagner. And Black's subbed in for Fultz. Here's Gobert. Hasn't made one yet. Here's Edwards. It's in there. Conley with the assist.
Well, we know this about Anthony Edwards. This guy, one of the stronger guards in this game. That's a tough finish.
And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. And the latest now from our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. David, it's all yours. Take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. The Orlando Magic is rolling out with some long and rangy athletes. They've got some size and the foundations of an identity. One scout recently said, everyone talks about playing positionless basketball, but they're the only ones who have really said, what the heck, let's do it. Kevin?
They've got a type, don't they, David? Thank you.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he makes the first. Greg, here he is, the first overall pick of the 2022 draft, Paolo Banchero.
And the top pick because he's a 6'10 playmaker. Banchero has a tremendous feel for the game, great vision, passing it, and endless potential offensively.
Alexander Walker, he's checked in for Edwards.
Banchero, one of those big men that does a little bit of everything, and the scary thing is he's got tremendous upside.
Conley kicks to Gobert. Pass to McDaniels. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
And they've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball in the paint.
Here's Black, over by Conley. Passes it to Bijanjic. Back to Wagner. Good ball movement here by the Magic. Five to shoot. Here's Black. No good on that one. And so it's Conley bringing up the ball for Minnesota. Only giving up six here in this quarter. Towns wide open. It's good. This game is all even.
And drifting to the corner and finding some space. Towns can exploit any gap in a defense.
Here's Black. Nothing on the board. There's 57 seconds left in the first half of the game. Feeds it to Banchero. Count it. Good. Banchero's got four this quarter.
Really well done there. Just confident and composed. Never in a hurry.
Conley surveying the D. From outside the arc, and again, Minnesota with the triple.
Yeah, there's 6 points on consecutive three balls. They're finding holes now in the deep.
The shot and game clock separated by four. At the elbow, Suggs. Here's the screen. The Magic need to get a shot off here. A three ball. Gets the three-pointer to fall. And the Magic lead by two.
Well, you see, it's 6'4" with excellent lift on his jumper. Jalen Suggs has no trouble scoring over good contest.
So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle underway in this one. Orlando out in front, leading by just two. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports.
Thanks for tuning in. The story tonight with the Minnesota Timberwolves, they're in a close game. Guys, what do you think the coaches are saying in the locker room right now?
Same thing I always say after this show. Big fella, you are good, but you could be better.
All the great ones continue to improve.
Shaq, taking the high road. I don't know that I've ever seen that. And talking about our game involving the Magic, not a lot of separation here at the half.
When you look at the metrics, they've done a great job offensively, really focused on getting the most out of each possession. The execution has been sharp. I love how they're playing right now.
Hold on just a second. I'm just trying to wrap my head around that, Kenny. You saying when you look at the metrics? Yeah, right. Thanks for spending halftime with us. Time to get it back out to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third quarter.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been fairly even so far. Well, you have to like what we're seeing so far from Paolo Banchero.
Man, how about the amount he's contributing in the scoring column through two quarters? He has been terrific.
And one would expect that the defense made some adjustments at halftime, but he has the ability to answer right back.
The wing set for him, Edwards and McDaniel. Towns and Gobert hold down the post for him. And it's Conley in at the one spot. That's Chris Finch's five as we get into the second half.
Listen, at just over 7 feet, we know Gobert is going to be terrific on the glass.
The Magic shooting at 50% in a decent groove. Here's Black, covered by Conley. Black dishes to Banchero. Rebounded by the Timberwolves. Gobert's got rebound number 5 here tonight. A moment now to hear from our sideline reporter, Hall of Famer David Alder. David.
Thanks very much. Wendell Carter Jr. didn't break through in his first stop with the Bulls, but he's become a cornerstone player with the Magic. What he says is, I've definitely tapped into a different side of myself. Defensively, being able to guard 1 through 5. Just continuing to go up from there and helping my team. Kevin?
Good stuff, D.A. Thank you. And that one is good from Suggs.
Boy, what a burst of speed on the drive from Jalen Suggs. Leaves the defender in the rear view.
Outside Conley. Kicks it to McDaniels. Outside Edwards. Pass to Conley. Baseline jumper. That shot misses. Orlando with the ball. They've got the Pistons ahead of them in their next game in Detroit. And that game will be 4 out of 5 on the road for the team. Here's Suggs. And it's off from 3-point range. The Timberwolves have gone 2-4 here to start the second half. Outside Edwards. Towns against Banchero. Right side Towns. Here's Conley. It's hauled in by the Magic. Not quite 2.5 minutes played here in the second half. Wagner passes to Suggs. Back to Wagner. Banchero has screened for Wagner. Over Conley. And it's Wagner missing.
Listen, offensively, they're very comfortable with him taking that shot. It's a good look under very little pressure. He just can't convert.
Now here is Conley. Looking at his point production, he averages almost 11 points a game. Tries the spin move. Gobert with a screen for Conley. And once again off the mark by Minnesota.
And the rebound battle split evenly thus far.
Wagner with it. Conley picks him up. He muscles it in through the contact and they call the foul. He's on his way to the free throw line.
That shows you the combination of size, strength from Franz Wagner. Like, seriously, well done right there.
Adore's talking about the young Franz Wagner. He's already proven how valuable he is.
Oh, Kevin, there's no doubt. For Wagner, this is a swingman who does a little bit of everything. He can shoot it. He can put it on the deck. He can make his teammates look good. A scorer from all three levels. There is not a lot to pick at where Franz Wagner is concerned. Wagner so fundamentally sound. This guy's so clever, plays with a ton of energy.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
And there's the pass to Edwards. And that one falls, coming off Conley's feet. Edwards got four this quarter. .130 left here in the third quarter. Here's Black, covered by Conley. Wagner kicks to Suggs. On target from 13 feet. Suggs has got seven.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Now here's Conley. T right on him. Pass to Edwards. Now Anderson launches a three, drops in the tray. Anderson's got the game tied up here for the Timberwolves.
And Anthony Edwards plays with joy, and you love to see him get his teammates involved. Pretty pass.
Suggs with the ball. Edwards there, and that one's good. Suggs. Here is Conley. .30 seconds left to play here in the third for the lead. And another three for Minnesota.
Yeah, D with very little pressure on their perimeter shooters. Three of the last five baskets they've allowed have been from beyond.
Now, here's Wagner. 8 points for him. Wagner has a screen on Anderson. It counts, and the foul. That one is on Towns.
When you are in the painted area, you've got to be calm under pressure. Mr. Wagner, yes, sir.
This is his second trip to the free throw line. That one misses. We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. Magic lead by one. And we're coming back in just a moment. Get ready for the fourth quarter of action when we return. And let's go back to a terrific pass that we're calling tonight our State Farm Assist of the Game.
And he's always been the favorite to bag this honor. These kind of feeds are his bread and butter.
Well, this is why great point guard play is so critical in today's NBA. And you see it right there on display.
Well, this has been a great contest so far. And I imagine the fourth quarter could have even more action in store for us. So on the floor for Orlando. They've got Fultz, Carter out there with Wagner. Then there's Bancaro, and it's Anthony in at the two-guard position. Now here's Reed. There's the pick. Here's Alexander Walker. Bullseye. And the Timberwolves lead by one. we've seen some great competition in this one.
Yeah, 7 already in the game, and I think it shows you how well these two teams match up with one another.
Wagner passes to Anthony. Off target from outside. The Timberwolves shooting 48% from the field. Not bad at all. To the middle. And a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
Well, he's such a good athlete for a center. It's how he's able to succeed despite being one of the smallest fives in the NBA.
The Magic trail by 3. Fultz looking around. Banchero outside. And it's Anthony at the elbow. It's stolen by Edwards. And now the Timberwolves on the break. Final quarter of play, about a minute and a half off the clock into it. Just 5 on the clock. And there's another one for the Timberwolves.
And they're scoring much more efficiently here in the second half, and they've gotten that field goal percentage above 50.
Time call here. The Magic decide to talk it over. Big group substitution now for Minnesota. Gobert, he's checked in for Reed. Karl Anthony Towns comes in for Anderson. Nick Daniels, he's checked in for Alexander Walker. And it's Conley in for Shake Milton. So Orlando going with an almost entirely new group here. Goga Bitadze's checked in for Wendell Carter. Franz Wagner comes in for Wagner. Jalen Suggs is checked in for Cole Anthony. And Black's subbed in for Markelle Fultz. It's time now to hear from our Hall of Fame reporter, David Aldridge. What's the latest, David?
I was able to listen in on what Jamal Mosley was going over with his team. Now, he's not happy with the perimeter defense. He told them we have to hustle more out to the three-point line because they look real comfortable out there now. I want you contesting every three they put up. We'll see if that intensity increases on D, guys.
Thanks, David. Bitadze with the bucket. Minnesota leading by 3. Outside Conley. Towns down low. Banchero's there. Outside Edwards. 5 on the clock. Passes to Towns. The tray knocks down the 3-ball. Towns has got the lead up to 6 now for the Timberwolves.
And they have been relentless from deep, and you see the defense trying to react, but to no avail.
Well, that's the whole point, isn't it? If you space the floor well enough, it's almost impossible for the defense to account for everyone.
And here's Banchero. After the three-pointer from Karl Anthony Towns, Banchero kicks to Black. Banchero has screen on Conley. Towns with the steal. To the inside. And finished off by McDaniel.
I'll tell you, right now, these guys cannot be stopped.
Boy, it looks like their confidence is at an all-time high, just feeding off each other right now.
And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. Hans Bass Wagner, here's Ben Carroll. And that one clearly a foul, gets the whistle, and two shots coming up.
You can see Paolo Banchero plays with such a high energy level at the offensive end. So determined right there.
And a closer look here at the hustle stats for Minnesota.
They have been a wrecking ball defensively, coming up with steals, being active with their hands, and just doing a terrific job of disrupting the rhythm.
I think it's also important we have to acknowledge how many scoring opportunities they've created from their spectacular defense, getting a bunch of points off turnovers.
Cannot convert on the second. That misses.
You know, he doesn't shrink the lead as much as he should have. That hurts a bit.
Has to go there. And here's Edwards. Shot clock at five. And it's Wagner with the rebound. And Wagner's got the ball here for the Magic. Banchero with the ball. Conley picks him up. Doubled by Conley. Banchero kicks to Suggs. Sinks the triple.
Jalen Suggs, a big-time bucket. This guy is fearless.
And a little over 3.5 minutes in the books so far here in the fourth. Edwards inside. The pass to Conley. Down low. And that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession.
Active hands from him as he's able to deflect that pass out of bounds.
Well, that's what you call a game of inches. They talk about it in football. We see it right there.
There's a minute left in the fourth quarter of this one. Lando's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Now, here's Banchero. McDaniels defending. Banchero passes to be Johnson. Just five to shoot. Inside, Wagner. Rebounded by the Timberwolves.
Pressured that shot by getting the hand up just as good as a block.
And he did it without fouling, and that's become an art, changing shots without making contact.
And so they choose to intentionally foul. Good on the first, and that puts them up by five. And he is unable to get the second one.
They've got to take the first good shot they can find.
And they've got to be efficient with the clock. Quick score, quick foul.
About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. It falls! What a beautiful shot to bring him to within three.
Well, Jalen Suggs, despite his youth, proving he's willing to step up when his team needs him.
No choice but to foul there, but he's probably the last guy you want to see on the line.
Shooting two.
Gets the first, and that gives them a four-point cushion.
All eyes are on Conley, a normally confident shooter. Can he sink the free throw?
Second second one is good. Getting both at the line, and it's a five-point game.
And I don't need to tell you guys, those free throws are big. Two-possession game now.
Time call here. The Magic decide to talk it over. They're trailing by five. 16 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
Trying to stay alive, they've got to work quickly.
This is the very definition of desperation mode right now. They need a quick shot and a quick foul. Seconds left in the fourth quarter. Fires the three. It's good! And he has brought them to within 2 points.
And you can't get a bigger bucket than that.
I'll tell you, it takes confidence to pull the trigger in that situation. You love guys who relish the moment.
Yeah, you have to do that, though. You can't just let them dribble the game out.
So the first one drops, and that makes it a 3-point lead.
Now here's a guy with a great deal of experience in these situations. Mike Conley's team very confident with his chance to deliver at the foul line.
Second free throw, no good that time. He really wanted that one. Now a timeout called by Orlando. They're behind by three. 9 seconds left here in the fourth quarter.
a three and nothing but a three will do here.
You've got to keep your composure and execute to get a quality look from three.
They're going to prolong the game here with an intentional foul. First free throw is good, and that gives them a four-point cushion. And so he drops them both. It's a five-point game.
Well, what a performer this guy is. Game is on the line. He stands up and delivers.
And so Minnesota takes the win. They didn't make it easy on themselves or their fans. But in the end, everyone's satisfied.
Well, I mean, there were some times that momentum shifted, and especially early on. But let's give this group a lot of credit for that stick-to-itiveness in terms of finishing out and executing that game plan.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much. Rudy, what did the bench do to help you get this win tonight?
They've been huge. You know, they brought us back in the game, and everyone contributed. You know, it wasn't an easy night for us at the beginning, but we kept fighting, and it's a big win for us.
And I'm sure you want to keep it going, man. Congrats. Back to you guys.
Thank you, David. And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, and the rest of our terrific crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. As New Balance presents our player of the game, Anthony Edwards. Thank you.